Earthquakes are by no means a rare phenomenon. It's estimated that the Earth is rocked by around 500,000 quakes every single year. Most are clustered around the fault lines that divide the Earth's tectonic plates, but others form deeper in the mantle and could strike anywhere in the world. Most of these earthquakes cause no damage and can't even be detected without specialist equipment. Large earthquakes are considerably rarer, which is fortunate as they can cause immense destruction over vast distances, creating killer tsunamis and even ultimately triggering volcanic eruptions. In the video today, we're looking at 10 of the most devastating earthquakes that have ever been recorded. Number 10. 1960 Valdivia Earthquake. In 1935, an American seismologist by the name of Charles Richter devised the famous Richter magnitude scale. By measuring seismographic readings and then cross-referencing them with the distance from the seismographic disturbance, it became possible to measure the magnitude of an earthquake. The Richter scale increases exponentially, so a magnitude 7 isn't just slightly bigger than a 6 magnitude earthquake, it is 10 times bigger, and a magnitude 8 is again 10 times more powerful than a 7. By far the biggest earthquake ever measured, and by quite some distance, was the 1960 Valdivia earthquake off the coast of Chile. The megaquake was measured at an enormous 9.5 on the magnitude scale, releasing roughly the same energy as 100 million tons of TNT. It literally shook the entire world, with shockwaves traveling down as far as the Earth's molten core. It triggered tsunamis that traveled more than 10,000 miles across the Pacific Ocean, killing hundreds of people as far away as Japan, Hawaii, and Australia. Chile was the closest to the epicenter, and it suffered the worst of the devastation. Fortunately, however, the areas worst affected were sparsely populated. More than 5,000 people lost their lives, and 2 million people were made homeless. But given the ferocity of the earthquake, this could easily have been a great deal worse. Number 9. 1906 San Francisco Earthquake. The infamous San Andreas Fault runs for almost 800 miles straight through the American state of California. It forms the barrier between two of the largest tectonic plates that divide the surface of the Earth. California is effectively sitting on a ticking time bomb. None of this was widely understood by the residents of San Francisco when they were violently awakened just after 5 a.m. on April the 18th, 1906. The Earth shook for almost a minute in an earthquake estimated to have been as high as around 8 on the Richter scale. As devastating as the earthquake itself was, the fires that burned across San Francisco for 3 days caused the greatest loss of life. With water pipes across the city ruptured, firefighters struggled to bring the blazes under control, and huge swaths of the city were just destroyed. More than 3,000 people were killed, and an astonishing 400,000 were left homeless. Rebuilding the ruined city cost an estimated $400 million, which equates to around $10 billion in today's money. Number 8. 2008 Sichuan Earthquake. Until quite recently, Baihuan was a thriving town in central China. Now it's a ghost town, its buildings in ruins, and its inhabitants either dead or relocated. Around 80% of Baihuan's buildings were destroyed in the 2008 Sichuan earthquake. The damage was so extensive that the government decided not to rebuild the town. It's now preserved almost exactly as it was in the immediate aftermath of the disaster, and it serves as a macabre tourist attraction. While Baihuan was the worst hit, the destruction ranged over a much wider area. Around 87,000 people are believed to have lost their lives, and almost 500,000 more were made homeless. Numerous public buildings, including several schools, collapsed with substantial loss of life, exposing substandard construction standards. China boasts the second richest economy in the world, but the 7.9 magnitude earthquake caused enough destruction to compel the Chinese government to take the slightly embarrassing step of requesting foreign aid to assist in the repair and relief effort. Number 7. The Great Kanto Earthquake. Struck by as many as 1,500 earthquakes per year, Japan is one of the planet's hotspots for seismic activity. It is for this reason that Japan has become the most prepared nation on the planet. Emergency drills are regularly practiced, new buildings are required by law to be earthquake resistant, and there is even an early warning app bundled with every smartphone. When a huge earthquake struck Tokyo and its surrounding areas on September 1, 1923, things were very, very different. Most Japanese buildings at the time were made of paper and wood. They stood no chance against an earthquake measuring 7.9 on the Richter scale. To make matters worse, the quake struck at midday, just as many Japanese were lighting fires to cook their meals. The resulting conflagration was so intense that it melted metal and claimed thousands of lives. The flames sucked in oxygen from the surrounding areas, creating firestorms much like those created by the Hug bombing raids of World War II. Some 44,000 people sought shelter by the banks of the River Sumida. Only about 300 of them survived after a wall of flame swept over them. The final death toll is unknown, but it's believed that more than 140,000 people lost their lives in the disaster. 500,000 more were left homeless. It has even been suggested that the disaster sapped Japan of her optimism and helped set her on the path to an aggressively nationalistic authoritarian rule. Number 6. Great Tohoku Earthquake. On March 11, 2011, seismometers registered one of the largest earthquakes ever recorded. 80 miles east of Japan, the fault between two tectonic plates slipped by a record 50 meters. It released forces so great that it shifted the planet's tilt on its axis and shortened its days by a fraction of a second. Recorded as an 8.9 on the Richter scale, this earthquake was vastly more powerful than the great Kanto earthquake that had unleashed such devastation on Japan in 1923. Japan's population then had been about 58 million people. In 2011, it was closer to 130 million. Japan's defenses proved themselves to be equal to the quake itself. In Tokyo and elsewhere, skyscrapers swayed alarmingly as they were violently shaken for 6 long minutes. It is a testimony to exacting Japanese construction standards that none of them collapsed, but many inhabitants nonetheless, they quickly reassessed the wisdom of living so far above the ground. However, this was not it, and much worse was to come. The earthquake had created a huge tsunami, and it was rushing towards the coast at more than 500 miles per hour, which is roughly the cruising speed of a Boeing 737 jet airliner. The Japanese government had invested in substantial sea defenses to guard against such an eventuality. Despite the considerable preparations that Japan had put into place, 22,000 people were killed, and the damages ran into something in the region of $360 billion. Number 5. The Japan Lisbon Earthquake. For the first half of the 18th century, Portugal counted herself among the world's great powers. The Portuguese Empire was one of the oldest in the world, made rich from the boatloads of gold and diamonds that were imported from South America. The prosperity it was shaken on November 1, 1755, when the Kingdom of Portugal suffered one of history's deadliest earthquakes. The quake itself lasted for between 3 and 6 minutes. It was felt as far afield as Finland, but the worst of the destruction it centered upon the Portuguese city of Lisbon. Around 40 minutes after the ground had stopped shaking, survivors witnessed the remarkable sight of the sea retreating from the city's harbor. They were then faced with the even more startling sight of it rushing back in the form of a 9-yard-high tsunami. After the earthquake and the tsunami came the fires. And as with so many similar disasters, it was these that caused the greatest loss of life. The extent of the devastation can only be guessed at. 100,000 people may have lost their lives in Lisbon alone, with tens of thousands more casualties in Spain and Morocco. The earthquake cost Portugal almost half of its entire yearly GDP, and the king was so traumatized he became terrified of spending any time in walled buildings, instead moving his royal courts to a complex of tents. This trauma and devastation hastened Portugal's demise as a great power. Number 4. 2010 Haiti Earthquake. Countries such as the United States of America and Japan have the economic power and technological know-how to mitigate against the impact of all but the most catastrophic of natural disasters. Most nations, though, they aren't so fortunate, and Haiti is particularly vulnerable. Haiti is the poorest nation in the entire Western Hemisphere and one of the most impoverished in the world. It's regularly battered by hurricanes, cyclones, and tropical storms, and it has the misfortune of sitting dangerously close to no less than 2 major fault lines. For the entirety of the 20th century, Haiti was lucky. It suffered only 2 earthquakes of any note, and they claimed fewer than 10 lives. This changed in 2010 in catastrophic fashion. The earthquake that struck Haiti in the early evening measured 7 on the magnitude scale, which was large but nowhere near the largest ever recorded. However, the fact that the quake occurred only a few miles beneath the surface, combined with Haiti's poor infrastructure and total lack of building regulations, contributed to the appalling damage and vast loss of life. Number 3. 1138 Aleppo Earthquake. The Dead Sea Rift is the name given to the fault line separating the Arabian and African tectonic plates. It cuts through Israel, Syria, Lebanon, and Jordan, and as one of the few major fault lines not inconveniently located at the bottom of an ocean, it's one of the most studied in the world. For the last several hundred years, notable earthquakes have been a rarity in the Middle East, but in the 12th century and early 13th century, a cluster of them struck over a relatively short period of time. The 1138 Aleppo earthquake was the most destructive of them all and one of the most devastating in history. 1138 was already a lively time in the Middle East's eventful history. The Crusades were in full swing, with the invading Christian armies from Europe attempting to drive the Muslims from the Holy Land. The earthquake of 1138 made no distinction between these groups. The town of Aleppo, a Muslim stronghold, was almost totally destroyed. Meanwhile, numerous forts and citadels manned by the Crusaders tumbled to the ground. Something in the region of 250,000 people are believed to have been killed. Number 2. 2004 Indian Ocean Earthquake. Over the last two decades, there has been an increase in the number of major earthquakes around the globe. Scientists still aren't entirely sure why this would be, but the most catastrophic of them was the 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake. The quake struck beneath the Indian Ocean on December 26, 2004, at 9.1 on the Richter scale. This made it one of the most powerful earthquakes ever recorded. Despite the immense energy released, only one Indonesian city reported any damage. Scientists had been monitoring the earthquake, but they didn't yet know whether it had generated a tsunami. While the Pacific Ocean had early warning sensors capable of detecting tsunamis, in 2004, nothing of this sort existed in the Indian Ocean. 32 minutes after the quake, the question was answered when the first of a series of tsunamis slammed into Indonesia. Over the course of 6 hours, another 13 countries were hit with what quickly became one of the worst natural disasters in history. More than 220,000 people were killed and 500,000 more had their homes destroyed. The material cost of this disaster is estimated at $15 billion. Number 1. 1556 Shaanxi Earthquake. China holds the unwanted distinction of having suffered all three of the worst natural disasters on record. The first two of these were the floods of 1887 and 1931, while the third was the 1556 earthquake centered on the Shaanxi province in northwest China. Scientists who have studied the quake believe it would have struck with a force of around 8 on the magnitude scale, and it caused immense devastation over a huge area. Whilst accurate figures are impossible to come by, it's believed that more than 800,000 people lost their lives. This included more than 60% of the densely populated Shaanxi province. The pressure created was so great that in places, soil liquefaction occurred. This is a process whereby previously solid ground takes on the properties of a liquid with disastrous consequences for anything on the surface. Even the most sturdily constructed buildings would be at serious risk of collapse with their foundations so fatally compromised. And of course, in 16th century China, few buildings were well constructed to begin with. China is crisscrossed by fault lines, and it has been struck by dozens of major earthquakes, some of which have even exceeded the 1556 quake in magnitude. However, the Shaanxi earthquake remains the most devastating on record. So I'm not going to ask if you enjoyed that video, but I do hope you found it interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. If you're looking for more stuff, we've got videos every day of the week, so subscribe and you'll be told about those. Also, check out videos from our archive, some are linked to on the screen now. And if you want another channel by me, I'm linking that in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching.